Anywhere in Lee County, you've noticed it. We are growing fast. But is it too fast? NBC2 investigator Evan Dean discovers the answer may not be an if, but a where.
How about this for proof of the mass migration to the Sun Belt? Back in Detroit, Michigan, in 1950, 1.85 million people lived in the city. Here in Lee County, just 23,000 people. But now take a look. More than 70 years later, what a difference. Just 620,000 people live in Detroit. And here in Lee County, we're at more than 800,000 people.
Came down here and played golf and fell in love with the area. And here we are.
A winter visit with a few rounds of golf here was all Troy Hall needed, and last year made it permanent, moving from Michigan to Southwest Cape Coral.
I spent my whole career climbing the corporate ladder, and I finally just decided it was all about quality of life.
He isn't the only one. Just across the street, another soon-to-be new neighbor on the block. In fact, Cape Coral is the ninth fastest growing city in the country. 154,000 were here in 2010. Now, there's nearly 217,000 people. Over in Lehigh Acres, the population grew 31% from 2010 to 2020 and continues to surge.
Everybody that we know wants to be south. If they haven't moved or don't plan on moving, they'd love to move even if they could.
It's not just a population boom in Lee County. It's business, too, especially here off Alico Road. The county's economic development office says 70% of all commercial investment in Lee the past 2 years is here.
There was a lot of open fields, and there are no more open fields.
Michael Bracco is director of operations for Privada Private Label, a skin and hair care company. They were among the earliest to move to the area. They've watched it transform.
There is construction going on in almost every green space you can see on the Alico Corridor.
But all this growth isn't all good. With it, there's a clear challenge. The places people move to most, like the Cape and Lehigh, are not big draws for business.
That has led us to the longest commutes of any county in the state of Florida.
John Talmadge is director of the Lee County Economic Development Office. He says those commutes are one of the reasons traffic has gotten so bad, especially on Daniels Parkway and here on Colonial Boulevard.
There's just too many hundreds of thousands of cars traveling up and down those roads every day.
Road extension projects are in the works to relieve some of that congestion. Another solution is fixing up places like this. Despite all the new business in our area, some spots somehow still sit abandoned. This old shopping plaza in North Fort Myers is now just a shortcut for drivers.
And we need the growth to continue so that it's more spread out more equitably throughout the county and not just focused in certain parts of the county.
Before long, Lee County could be home to more than 1 million people. The answer isn't trying to slow the growth. It's making sure it happens in the right spots.
I hope Cape Coral sees a real migration of professional services, lawyers, accountants, doctors, to give them the commercial footprint that they want that will allow them to continue to develop going north.
I think growth is good within reason. If it's managed and controlled to a point, I think growth is good.
Reporting for the NBC2 Investigators, I'm Evan Dean.